Hey, I'm Craven and I need your thoughts. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe. Those subscriptions are picking up a few, and comments, I need as many of those as you can give me. So please hit that like button as well. So last week we talked a little bit about root cellars. This week we're going to talk about something to go in the root cellar. And this is something that I need to make some early statements. I recommend using standard canning jars, canning lids. It's recommended that you use brand new lids every time. There are some people that reuse lids. My statement is not to say that you shouldn't do that. Absolutely, that's the way you should go. That's the best way. That's going to keep the food the best. However, my grandmother had taught me something many decades ago that I haven't seen anywhere. And so I wanted to put a video out on it and make sure if you know something about this, anybody out there, comment on this. Let me know what it is that your parents or grandparents have taught you or what you'd learned on this. My grandmother was a product of the Great Depression. So she was as tight financially as you could get. It's how they accumulated some semblance of a wonderful life, even having almost no education and just hard work. But one of the things that her mother had taught her during the Depression was, and now understand, they didn't have the USDA to have the special times that you're supposed to use for cooking the vegetables, to can it properly, do all these things. A lot of that information just simply was not available. You did it according to what somebody had taught you. And so that was the way she went about it, was this is how her mother had taught her. This is how she'd done it her entire life. She never paid attention to those cook times for the jams that she put up, the jellies, the vegetables that she put up. She did have a plethora of jars. And I find myself today going to do a video and find that I have no canning jars that don't have something in it. So I've got a jar here that has got liquid in it already, so that we can have a visualization of the height. So my grandmother would fill her cans up to that level, and you can see that it's just over the edge before the, and it's still got some round spot, a little bit of round spot to it before it gets to the straight neck of the jar. And at that point, while the liquid is still cooling, since she had no lids, she would pour a little bit of beeswax that still had some honey in it that she'd just heated up right on top. Now that would float right on top of whatever liquid she had. And she'd let that cool. So now we have a layer of beeswax, and it wasn't much. It was maybe an eighth of an inch of beeswax that she would pour on top of each of the jars, each of the liquids, whether it was a jam, whether it was a jelly, whether it was green beans that she'd canned, or peas, or whatever it was that she was canning that day. And then after that had fully cooled, she took wax, not paraffin wax, but hard wax, and used it pour on top of the beeswax. And she'd put a good 1/4 inch, 5/16 of an inch of hard wax on top of that after wiping out the inside of the rim to make sure that the rim was completely clean. That's when she'd pour it in. Let that harden. And she put it up. And I remember as a child breaking the wax on top of jellies and green beans and peas, and we open those up and eat them. And grandma'd say that that can was 4 years old or 5 years old. Never had a problem. Understand, I'm not recommending that today. That would be but at some point, if we don't have lids, and the future's a long time, so at some point, this might become our standard method of canning our produce and our jams and jellies and things of that nature. She never canned meats, so I don't know how, because typically you pressure can meats, not or hot soak or whatever. I'm not sure what you call it, but pressure canning is typically used on meats, but she never did canned meats. So don't know if that same process would work there. I think the process may work specifically because we know that beeswax has, bees or honey has, and so beeswax as well has some natural antibiotic qualities to it. Those natural antibiotic qualities keep any bacteria from growing at the top of the jar. So sealing it with wax, it seems like it might work to me. I know my grandmother did it for many years, and don't ever remember having a problem with any of those. And you could always see if the wax was broken, she'd say, don't eat that. So, and I only ever saw a couple jars that the wax had ever broken on. So that's what I wanted to provide to you today. I know, I still want to say that we should stay with the regular recipes. Get extra canning lids. Save those for as long as you can. Use those for as long as you can. But at some point, with a future that we're talking about, those things may run out. So in that case, we still need to can. We still need to preserve our food to make it to the next season. So maybe that will help some of us out. So I'm Craven, and I need your thoughts. Like, comment, subscribe. If you know something about this, you've done this yourself, please throw a comment in there and let me add that to a future video. I appreciate y'all.